Why don't you go up to your principal someday or your parents and tell them to go fuck an iceberg? They really appreciate that. Anyway, welcome to the first episode of the show. New interactive type vlog for my fans, you guys. So, we'll start off the show with something really ridiculous. I found a link on internet for, it's on the site Den of Geek. And they came up with this list of really ridiculous horror movie titles. And basically I'll read them off to you and, well, I'll give my thoughts on some of them. So, Weasels Rip My Flesh and Other Deathless Horror Movie Titles. A Fairy's Mandarin Duck. Really? What the fuck? A Fairy's Mandarin Duck. Is it like a really bad Chinese, you know, translation? Or is it just, you know, Fairy's Mandarin Duck, you know? I don't know. Attack of the Flesh Devouring Space Worms from Outer Space. First off, that title was an oxymoron. It was a moron who wrote that title. You already said they were from space when you said Attack of the Flesh Devouring Space Worms from Outer Space. And if you add from outer space, you sound like a dumbass. Next title, Beautiful Dead Body. That sounds really creepy. Maybe it's a movie for necrophiliacs. Yeah, wasn't there a movie called Necrophilia anyway? Or Necromantic? Necromantic, that's what it is. It's a fucked up movie about some guy who fucks a dead body. Beauty with No Neck. Yeah, because decapitations are just beautiful. They are always beautiful. Yeah, right. Bela Lugosi Meets a Brooklyn Gorilla. That's a classic title, but you know what you're getting into when you rent a movie called, or buy a movie called Bela Lugosi Meets a Brooklyn Gorilla. What makes a Brooklyn Gorilla anyway? Does it have a special accent? Does a gorilla walk around with a cigar? Does it walk around with a Dodgers uniform? I don't know. Brooklyn Gorilla. Is it a lot different than a New Jersey Gorilla? Jersey Gorilla is probably, you know, in the club. Better Sex Through Yoga. Wow, I don't even know if that's a horror film. IMDb listed as a horror film. Must be a flub. Blood of Ghastly Horror. First off, that title doesn't make any sense. Blood Slaves of the Vampire Wolf. Blood Slaves of the Vampire Wolf. So is it like a werewolf vampire? Is it a vamp wolf? Classic. Bloody Parrot. What is that, like the parrot sketch from Monty Python? Hello! Hello! Oh no, the parrot's bleeding! Hello! Bog. Well, I know about Bog, and that movie sucks. Bog is a dreadfully dull movie from the 80s, 1983, which has a creature that, well, the movie feels like it was made in 1976. Bad acting, horrible music, shitty monster, and the movie's rated PG. Enough said. Breakfast of Aliens. Yeah. Breakfast of Aliens. Breakfast of Imbeciles. Classic. Bride of Killer Nerd. So, let me guess, is this a sequel to Killer Nerd? Are they following the, you know, the Bride of Reanimator style, you know, calling it Bride of Killer Nerd? Bummer. Bummer. Butt Crack. Yeah, Butt Crack, the movie. Canadian Mounties versus Atomic Invaders. Wow. Wow. Cannibal Roller Babes. Cannibal Roller Babes? Oh, hell yeah. It's gonna be like fucking, you know, rollerball with chicks and they eat people or some shit. Gory rollerball shit. That'd be awesome. No, I'm just playing around. Probably sucks. Daily Chicken. So what is it like? If you don't get your daily amount of chicken, you die or something? Or is it daily chicken? Is it like a ripoff on some news show, newspaper, you know, place, and it's called Daily Chicken instead of the Daily Planet? Probably about a super chicken, about the adventures of Super Chicken. You have Dance of the Dwarfs. Wow. Day of the Nightmare. Dead Dudes in the House. Wow, I've heard of that movie. Trying to be sort of like Bill and Ted, but with horror elements, and it just sucks. Dude, there's a zombie. Dude, you're a zombie, dude. Oh no. Excellent. Defula. Yeah, because deaf vampires are scary. Drainiac with an exclamation point. Because you have to have that exclamation point, right? You know, it can't be just Drainiac. It's got to be Drainiac! Ed and his dead mother, Steve Buscemi. That's all I got to say. He plays Ed. It's kind of fun. Fools in the Dark. Frankenstein meets the space monster. Geek Maggot Bingo. I don't know why. I've always loved that title. Gentlemen Don't Eat Poets. That's right, Gentlemen Don't Eat Poets. Get Pony Boy. I don't know if I want to buy a Pony Boy. Thank you. Ghost Cat of Arima Play Palace. The fuck? Ghoul Sex Squad. Wow! Ghoul Sex Squad. The GSS. Crazy. Was it like a softcore porn? Is it a porno version of Ghostbusters or some shit? Hardcore Poisoned Eyes. That makes no sense. Head Cheese. Wow. Hello, Dracula. I find that hilarious. Where you have Lionel Richie go, "Hello, is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. You wanna suck my blood, but I can't see you in the dark. Hello, is it me you're looking for? Help me, dot, 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 I'm possessed." Wasn't like, you know, you need to do the whole thing like, probably another Exorcist ripoff since it was released in 76. So it could be like, you know, help me, I'm possessed. Kind of like, you know, Martin Short in, Inner Space. It'd be like, I'm possessed, help me, I'm possessed. This one's hilarious. Do that from 2003. It's, "Hey, stop stabbing me. I shoot you not." That's the title of a movie. What is there, a sequence in the movie? Like some chick is stabbing the guy and it's like, "Hey! Stop stabbing me!" Stupid. Hide and Go Shriek. Transvestite killer. In a mall. Hollywood Chainsaw Hookers. Ah, Fredo and Ray. One of his classics. Very few good movies he's done. Also has, what the hell? It's Gunnar Hansen from who played Leatherface in the original in it. House of Psychotic Women. I bought a vampire motorcycle. That's funny. I bought a vampire motorcycle on StageFoo, so you might see that on my blog sometime. I Was a Teenage Mummy. So it's like, you gotta follow the I Was a Teenage Frankenstein, Was a Teenage Werewolf. Now it's I Was a Teenage Mummy. And no, it's not from the 50s, it's from 1992. Killer Fish. Yeah. Killing Bee. The fuck? Shouldn't it be Killer Bees? Or Killing Bees? Not Killing Bee. Is it just one bee in the movie? Is it like some giant fucking bee? Is it like fucking huge, like Mothra or some shit? Lake Dead. Long Pigs. What the fuck is a long pig? Look Who's Toxic. Ha. Was that like a parody of Look Who's Talking? Monsters A Go-Go. Monsters Crash the Pajama Party. My Mom's a Werewolf. I have fun with that one. John Saxon's in it. Naked You Die. What the hell? That doesn't make any sense. It's just like, Naked You Die. Naked You Die. Nude for Satan. Once upon a virgin suicide. Pig chicken suicide. What the fuck is that? Pig chicken suicide. I'm not making this shit up, folks. Pig chicken suicide. Please don't eat the babies. Yes, that actually is a title. Because it's totally rude and off-putting. And it's totally just... You just set a bad example when you eat babies. You know? You don't want to be known as a baby eater. Because baby eaters are bad. Psyched by the 4D witch. What the fuck? Okay, 4D witch? What's the difference between a 4D witch and a 3D witch or a 2D witch? What the fuck is 4D? I know there's a movie called 4D Man. Pumpkin zombies. Pumpkin zombies. Puss bucket. Ragaza tuta nuda assassinata de Nepalco. A totally nude woman killed in the park. That's the translation. Classic. Robo Vampire. I've seen the cover art for Robo Vampire, and it's totally a ripoff from RoboCop. They had this guy that literally, the picture looks like they literally just ripped off RoboCop as closely as they could without getting sued. Then they have some vampire, Chinese vampire dude in the corner. That's it. Santa Claus. It's not, you know, Santa Claus, you know, as C-L-A-U-S, it's C-L-A-W-S. It's so clever. No. Satan's cheerleaders. Go, Satan, go! Go, Satan, go! Say You Love Satan. Sounds like a TV show on the Stay Tuned channel. Science bastard. You are just one science bastard. Shriek of the Mutilated. Slave Girls from Beyond Infinity. So, you've downloaded a demon. What the fuck? Probably one of the dotted lines in the movie. So you've downloaded a demon, dude. You gotta do something about it. Before it fucks everybody up and starts puking a green pea soup all over everybody. Sorority Babes in the Slime Ball Bolorama. I love that title. Similar. Space Psychos 4. So there's 4 Space Psychos movies? Holy shit. Space Zombie Bingo! Succula. Well... Either it's a porno with some chick, vampire chick, who like to suck men's cocks, or it's just a shitty vampire movie that just sucks a lot. Teenagers Battle the Thing. No, it has nothing to do with the thing from this, you know, John Carpenter's, and I don't think it has to do with the thing from Fantasy Four either, so I don't know what the fuck it is. The Beautiful, the Bloody, and the Bear. That sounds like a softcore porno soap opera. The Creature Wasn't Nice. Oh, no shit. The Gay Bed and the Breakfast of Terror. What the fuck? Give me a break. How the hell is a bed gay? What is it like? Is it like covered in pink with like polka dots or some shit? Is that what makes it gay? What the hell? There's such a thing as a gay bed. Beds don't have sexuality, but... The Ghastly Ones. The Ghost in the Invisible Bikini. The Ghost Cat Cursed Pond. These have got to be like Japanese movies. The Mad Love Life of a Hot Vampire. Well, that's hot. The Mystery of the Ghastly Face. The Night of the Living Duck. Wow. That came out 2 years after Howard the Duck, too. The Night of the Living Duck. The Nostril Picker. There's a movie about a guy who picks his nose? Ew! What is he, like, go mine for gold and then it, like, is covered, like it kills people or something? Does he kill people with his boogers? He just goes like... No! Ah! That would be fucking lame. The rats are coming! The werewolves are here! What the hell? Okay, first it's rats. Oh no, they're rats! Oh no, werewolves! Ah, werewolves! Revenge of the Savage Bees. The Revenge of the Savage Bees. Man, those bees are pissed off. The Super Madman. Because Madman isn't enough, we gotta call him the Super Madman. The Vampire Beast Craves Blood. The Washing Machine. Yes, there's a movie called The Washing Machine. Wow, horrifying. There's a horror movie called The Washing Machine. Ah, no, don't put me in the spin cycle. There's also a movie called The Refrigerator. Did you know that in Back to the Future, originally, they wanted to do a refrigerator instead as a time machine instead of the DeLorean? Can you imagine how lame that would be? Be like, Marty, make sure to clean out the leftovers. They'll go bad twice as shit. They'll go... Oh, twice as shit, wow. They'll go bad twice as fast if we go to back in the... as soon as we go back into the future. Stupid. Alright, the werewolf versus vampire women. Three on a meat hook. Remember? Three on a meat hook. I don't know what we took, but we must have been really fucking high. Three on a meat hook. And then me hook and me. Vampire dentist. Yeah, because dentists aren't scary enough. They happen to be vampires. Vampire hookers. Vampire time travelers. Varan the Unbelievable. Violent shit. Yes, there's violent shit, and there's also violent shit, too. Weasels Rip My Flesh. That is a horrible movie. Werewolves on Wheels. Werewolves on motorcycles. West Wrestling Women versus the Aztec Mummy. Zebediah the Anthropophagus. Wow. Zebediah the Anthropophagus. Wow. That is something else. Zebediah the Anthropophagus. Alright, I'm actually on Den of Geek still, and they have this thing called the Worst Action Hero Names, which I degree... Oh, I told... This guy's an idiot. I disagree with all of these... This crap. He's saying Marion Cobretti's a worst name. Ah, shut the fuck up, dumbass. We get paid to make movie... Make post shit on this site, too. And you're calling that the worst act? Some of the Marion Cobretti, one of the worst names, and Chev Chelios, and Frank Shatter, and John Matrix. Fuck you. Three on a meter. Me look at me. I don't know where me. Da 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 da. Da da da. Yeah, sorry, just going through this. Yep. Yeah, I know you. You're like, wow, you haven't said anything yet. Well, I'm just looking at this list here. And all right. Okay. Let's go to the news here. I'm on movie hole right now. To the news, hey, the news part of the show, and talking about Smallville and how it's finally ending, thank God. And eventually, and now finally, Tom Welling's actually gonna wear the costume. About fucking time. I thought he would stay Clark Kent in Metropolis for years, for fucking years and years and years and years and years. Okay, here's Schwarzenegger, what he's gonna star in. It's called a hardcore action thriller called The Last Stand. Let me look at what he's gonna do. The Last Stand is a Ji-Woon Kim thriller about a lone border sheriff tasked with stopping an escaped drug dealer from crossing into Mexico in a supercar. Schwarzenegger would play the sheriff. And he did do a cartoon series, The Governator. It's actually, he did do that. But, alright, I don't mind that idea of The Last Stand. It's one of those things where I'm kind of like, I don't know. Let's just hope it's not like, you know, Machete, and that's to the whole, you know, the border, 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 the border. That would really suck. Oh, and in other news, Stallone actually is going to direct The Expendables 2. I saw it on the Den of Geek. There's some news they just talked about. They basically, some news that The Expendables 2 is going to be directed by Stallone. So originally Stallone said, oh, I'm not going to direct it. But I guess Stallone's like, you know, now Stallone's like, because this is confirmed, Justin Bieber? What the? Alright, that better have just been an April Fool's Day joke. I mean, it's for Justin Bieber and The Expendables 2. Okay, so this was April 8th. This is the news was today, actually. This news was announced that a few weeks back was revealed that Sylvester Stallone was not going to be taking the director's chair for The Expendables 2. And given that the aim of the new film was to give more prominent roles to newer cast members rather than the old, it came across as Stallone was looking to shoulder less of the work this time around. Well, the plans clear out of the window. While he seeks a director for his next project, Headshot, now that Wayne Kramer has left the film, Lionsgate has announced Stallone will indeed be directing Expendables 2. No further details as of yet have been forthcoming, although we already know that the film was due in August 2012. Okay, that's cool. Stallone gets to direct it again. And this must have been an April Fool's Day joke, because it was posted on, you know, the 31st, you know, of March. it's totally. That is a good April Fool's joke, that Justin Bieber will be in Expendables 2, and that he would end up, you know. Wow. That's a good April Fool's Day joke. A bit late since I didn't see it, but that's kind of cool. So back to Movie Hole. And I guess Hawkeye is gonna be in Thor. You know, Jeremy Renner's Hawkeye. The Red Skull image is just—it's just an action figure. It's not an actual image yet, so I'm not buying into it. You know, show me an actual photo, not of an action figure. Marvel. The Crow of Salvation, the Fab Frizzandello directing a reboot. Great. Jeff Most is the producer on the remake of Crow. 28 weeks later, director Juan Carlos Fresnadillo has been trapped to helm the reboot of The Crow, replacing Stephen Norrington, which is good. They're using the same character Brandon Lee played in the new film. So, this is basically from Relativity and Edward R. Pressman signed Juan Carlos Fresnadillo to direct The Pro. Start targeted for fall 2011. Relativity's media president of worldwide production, Tucker Tooley and Edward R. Pressman. Why does Edward R. Pressman sound familiar to me? Because I could have sworn that he's produced a lot of other fucking movies. Because that name really does sound familiar to me. Okay. Direct anything? Is this a producer? Okay. Well, that's why. He was actually a very famous producer. This guy produced Cherry 2000. He produced Sisters, you know, Brian De Palma. He executive produced Paradise Alan Stallone. He executive produced Conan the Barbarian. He produced Conan the Destroyer. He produced executive produced Crime Wave. He produced Cock Radio, produced Blue Steel, produced Martians Go Home, The Crow. He produced the original Crow. He also produced Street Fighter. He executive produced Judge Dredd. He executive produced the Crow Stairway to Heaven series. Yeah, okay. Okay, so announced today they closed the deal for Juan Carlos Fresnadillo 28 weeks later to direct a reinvention of The Crow, a 1994 smash hit film based on the comic book series and comic strip by James O'Barr. Relativity and Pressman will be teaming with Spain-based Apaches Entertainment on the production, which is targeted to start in fall 2011. Fresnadillo is best known for directing 28 Weeks Later, the post-apocalyptic horror sequel of 28 Weeks Later, not 20. Which he co-wrote and produced with a longtime producing partner, Apaches Entertainment, Enrique Lopez Lavin. Fresnadillo also directed the critically acclaimed Spanish-language film Intacto, and is currently produced in direction of Intruder, starring Clive Owen, also being produced by Apaches Entertainment. Fresnadillo will collaboratively develop the script once a writer is attached to adapt a screenplay. Casting has not yet been announced. The film is being produced by Edward R. Pressman, Jeff Most, Relativity CEO Ryan Cavanaugh, the Apaches Enrique Lopez Lavigne, and Belen Atienza. Relativity's Tuli, the fighter, will serve as production executive producer. Yeah, that's great. We got the guy who did The Fighter. I don't know. Oh, that is a good movie, though. The Fighter was won an Oscar, so I thought I was getting confused that they meant fighting. Will serve as executive producer Jose Ibanez, Pressman's Film Corporation, John Katz, and Apache Sanchez de la Vega serve as co-producers. The Crow adaptation will be a reboot of the iconic cult character Eric Draven, who's resurrected as the Crow to avenge his wife's murder so he can reunite with her in the hereafter. Juan Carlos Fresnadillo is incredibly talented and imaginative filmmaker, said Tuli. We're thrilled to have him at the helm and excited to work with Pressman and the Apaches believed to be a compelling, innovative, or imaginative in The Crow. I just don't see this working very well, since The Crow is a very classic film. You're not going to ever top Brandon Lee. May he rest in peace. I just think it's a stupid idea to remake the movie anyway, but I don't know. So, okay. Carrie Ann Moss is going to be in the Silent Hill sequel. Rain Kramer, the director of Headshot, left the project. He's reported Rain Kramer will no longer be directing Headshot, the hitman actioneer, said the star of Sylvester Stallone. Like only some saliva will take over as director. Alessandro Cannon's directed film tells of New Orleans hitman who teams up with an NYPD police officer to avenge his friend's death. Arnold Milchan, who worked Bruce Willis for many years, says he's thrilled and honored to be working with Arnold Sylvester Stallone's talent I've long admired. The creative team could not ask for a better partner than IM Global for this project. Running Scared was an okay movie, but I just don't know. It's not the 80s Running Scared. We're talking about the other one. Ah, great. Lindsay Lohan may be Miss Tessmacher in Superman. Give me a break. Seriously? Lindsay Lohan? No, she did not need to take over Valerie Perrin's role. Vanilla Ice is going to be in a new Adam Sandler movie called I Hate You Dad, which stars Sam Sandler and Andy Samberg, who I hate Andy Samberg. I will avoid that movie like a plague. Not just because Vanilla Ice is in it, because I hate Andy Samberg. I hate him. He's the most totally unfunny comedian I've ever seen in my life. He's just silly. He's doofy and he's a dumbass, and I just fuck. And you can go suck my dick. Fuck him. Sorry. I know I'm pissed off, but I don't like Andy Samberg. His SNL shit sucks. Sorry. If you like it, fine, but I think it's absolutely lame. Bill and Ted 3 script revealed. The plot is revealed. And, surprises me in thinking about it. I guess it got something to do with getting older. Roles become scarcer and scarcer, and wanted to reward their fans for support over the years. Whereas back when he was being chased for these other films, he was young and drowning offers. Keanu Reeves would rule out returning the role of Jack Travern for a new Speed sequel, let alone a Point Break follow-up, and yet is committed to a third Bill and Ted film. Reeves had always said there's got to be a story worth telling for him to do a movie, which is fair enough. Surely new Speed would encompass just as exciting tale as Bill and 3, right? Maybe Speed 2 put him off, but we're on Point Break, or whatever. It's nice to hear that Reeves hasn't forgotten his roots, and I say I'd reward the fans by returning to one of his trademark roles. Reeves tells MTV's movies blog the script for Bill and Ted 3 is just 6 weeks away from its in-hand-in date. Sounds like Reeves is definitely on board. Which I like that. I know a little bit, but I don't know. The fellas went off and cooked it up, Reeves says in response to the question about the storyline. I don't know what happened when they put the elements together. Still, Reeves offers a stumpy synopsis. When we last got together, part of it was that Bill and Ted were supposed to have written the song Save the World, and it hasn't happened. So now they've become kind of possessed by trying to do that. Then there's an element of time, and they have to go back. On a final, you know, I think it's a cool idea. I like that idea. I think it's a good idea. I am actually looking. I'm looking forward to it. Because if Alex Winter and Keanu Reeves are going to come back, I like the idea. It's a cool idea that they haven't made the song that's going to change the world yet. So they can be sitting around, you know, they're this big band, Wild Stallions is huge. And they're all like, you know, dude, you know, Bill, we haven't made the song and changed the world yet, dude. Yeah, no. Maybe I guess we should start writing songs then. Yeah. You know, I've always liked Bill and Ted. They're one of my favorite characters, one of the most favorite characters. So I really, really appreciate, you know, that would be really cool to see Bill and Ted 3 on the screen. I hope it gets made. The Governator. Ugh. Alright, well, this is live on the show, and I'm going to watch the Governator trailer. And they're going to watch it with me with sound.
It has been an honor to have served you for this past 8 years.
What is this, now the guy who did the Boondocks?
Governor, will you be returning to your life as a movie star?
Larry King.
No, Larry. I've had a great career, as you know, as a bodybuilder, as an actor, and as a politician. Now I'm going to be a private citizen once again. I won't be back.
I thought it was an April Fool's Day joke. It's not.
Mr. Robots rampaging through San Francisco.
This is so fucking lame. It's so stupid, so cheesy. I mean, it's Rambo Force to Freedom bad. It looks like fucking RoboCop. You know, RoboCop, Alpha Commando like shit. He's got some stupid kid that helps him out. Some shit, little girl or some shit. There's sunglasses and, of course, another cybernetic. What the fuck is this shit? Are you serious, Arnold? Why did you agree to do this? Is it like fucking Tron? This bicycle? Oh, God. Oh, this is fucking awful. His car's a transformer. It looks like Iron Man. No, these are bad guys. They look like Iron Man. Yes. Why the fuck are they using this song? Three, does this work with Arnold driving around in the car that looks like a fucking robot ass? No. This looks like a piece of shit. The animation looks cheap. It looks like animation from like 1996. It doesn't look anything different. Of course, he does the Matrix move there. Oh, God. I'm speechless. Are you fucking kidding me? What a fucking joke.
I'm back.
Coming 2012. Arnold, alright, I'm gonna use the line from he did in that Arnold used in Total Recall. Screw you! The Governator looks like shit. Oh my God, that is so fucking such a bunch of bullshit. Fuck that. Watch 4 minutes from Green Lantern now. Yes, Warner Brothers is confident. Well, I'll see how confident, you know, you really are. And I'm going to watch 4 minutes of Green Lantern right now, and we'll see how I feel about it. Oh, yeah, I got to watch an ad for Tron Legacy. I don't hate the movie. The more I think about it, though, the fact that Disney wants to be an a-hole and doesn't want to do Tron 3 to make enough money.
I'm not going home without you.
Even though it made a shit ton of money. So.
Disney Tron Legacy, the ultimate Blu-ray experience.
I already got it in DVD.
Blu-ray combo pack also includes 3D.
Following footage and abridged version of select scenes that premiered at WonderCon 2011. Okay, we got Sinistro here. Suit still looks fucking lame.
Greg Life has got
obviously CGI.
We face an unprecedented danger. An enemy powerful enough to destroy entire civilizations. Powerful enough to defeat our finest warrior, Abin Sur, whose line can never be replaced.
Alright, it's looking a bit better now with his special effects that day. They're showing him get out of the spaceship. That's pretty cool.
I'm badly wounded. Heading to the nearest inhabited planet for the selection process.
Here's Ryan Reynolds. His face just seems so out of place in this movie. Sorry.
Your name?
Haldurin.
The ring chose you.
Take it. Place the ring in the lantern.
Speak the oath.
Speak the oath, because everybody knows the oath.
The lantern looks good.
Haldurin,
do solemnly swear to pledge allegiance to a lantern that I got from a dying purple alien.
It actually worked? Are you fucking kidding me? He doesn't say the oath right.
No evil shall escape my sight.
Now he said it right.
Let those who worship evil's might beware my power. Green Lantern's light.
Or he actually pulled that off, that line, better than thought. It looks more polished, I agree. But it just still looks fake. That dude still looks like shit. It still looks so obviously CGI. It doesn't matter what Warner Brothers is doing. It looks so fake.
The protection of your identity is required. As you are the first human to be chosen,
you need to have an actual suit.
Here is.
That's what you need to have. Nice visuals and production design, but you need to have an actual costume.
The ring turns thought into reality.
I admit, this is a better. I wouldn't mind seeing it for its visuals and stuff.
We were created.
It looks a lot more watchable. Warner Brothers put more effort into it, obviously. It looks like they put a lot of the Green Lanterns, the other Green Lanterns.
I don't need to tell you your
Sinestro future. Looks good.
I don't need to
the
tell
costumes
you
look a little bit better in the CGI suits. They look more polished. Showing how the bad guy gets his powers.
Brightest day.
Alright, that looks better.
Blackest night. No evil shall escape.
Alright, Warner Brothers. Oh, that's fucking badass. He created a minigun with his fucking ring. That's cool.
Beware my power.
Green Lantern's light!
I actually got chills at the end of that. Okay, I actually want to see that now. Originally, I was ranting about it. All this looks like shit. It fucking looks lame. But now that I think about it, Warner Bros. Put a lot of effort into that, really. I mean, you should go check it out. I'm just saying, whatever the site is, go jump up on the link here. Check out the link. Check out the footage. It's bad. I mean, he creates a fucking minigun out of his ring in the scene. He's just like, it's a short scene, but it's badass. Alright, I give props to Warner Brothers. That looks a lot better than what the crap they were offering us before, but okay. Alright. Ryan Reynolds thinks that the Flash, he's trying to say that Bradley Cooper is Ryan Reynolds' idea of who should play the Flash in a movie. I don't know. If it's Wally West, okay, but if it's Barry Allen, no. Wally West is understandable. Wow, David Rash from Sledgehammer is taking over for Alec Baldwin in Men in Black 3. He's taking Black for the he's taking the role that Alec Baldwin had as the old Men in Black, you know, chief. I like David Rash, so it might be interesting to see him, what he could do with that. But at the same time, it's kind of like... So... This is new, so it takes some time to... Warner Brothers is going to cast a new Batman and a new Superman and a new Justice League movie. I don't like that idea. It's basically to save money. And I just think it kind of, it's like crap. Piranha 3 Double D is directed by John Gulager. And I think that's a good choice. John Gulager, he did the Feast film. And that looks cool. You know, Beast was a good movie, actually. So John Gulager is a good choice. Okay, Scream 4 and get two more sequels. So that's basically it. If Scream 4 makes money, I'm going to get two more sequels. From the TV spots that I've seen of Scream 4, it looks like a piece. It looks very forgettable. The line delivery by Courtney Cox is horrendous. You know, give me a best shot or some shit like that. Stupid. Bryan Cranston from, you know, Breaking Bad and Malcolm in the Middle is going to play the Ronnie Cox role in Les Wiseman's Total Recall reboot. I don't know. I just think the idea of rebooting the film is stupid. But if I wait till I see a trailer, because the original novel, will sell for a wholesale, or Dreams will sell for you wholesale, or something like that, by Philip K. Dick. It's a lot more different, you know. So, Stuart Beattie is going to write and direct a Frankenstein movie. Another Frankenstein movie? Sequels to X-Men The Last Stand in development. That would be nice. I want to see him do the Age of Apocalypse storyline. Some guy on YouTube did a really good edit. The Almighty Thor is sci-fi's rip-off on Thor, which stars Dan Speaker and Jan Bryant, the two sword masters for Steven Spielberg, the Hook. What the fuck are they talking about? Two sword masters. Yeah, The Almighty Thor is going to air on sci-fi, so it's another rip-off on sci-fi. Probably Asylum Pictures is doing it. Stupid. Can't believe they actually make money making shit like that. Listening to the public. It's insulting. The Tron 3 taser leaked. But the franchise isn't very likely to happen. And here's the teaser on YouTube, and no longer available due to a copyright claim by Disney. Of course! So, don't... Yeah. I saw the new Wonder Woman costume. It looks like shit. There's one photo that looks like she's pooping, literally. It looks like she's taking a shit. And that's great. Bryan Singer, why people hated Superman Returns. He'd like to remake the movie. Well, I'm sorry, Bryan Singer. You're just not going to be able to remake it. And you know why it sucks is because it's fucking boring. It has next to no action sequences, and Superman gets his ass kicked by Kumar. That's all I need to say, really. Ugh. So I think I'm pretty much done with this news here. Yep. Alright. So we got the news done here. Okay, I'm gonna look at the pictures real quick for the Fright Night remake real quick. Boy, they look like shit. Fuck that. That looks horrible. I know they're just photos, but come on, Dream. That looks like a trendy piece of shit. I mean, give me a break. Greg Gillespie's a talented filmmaker. Oh, regardless, you're not gonna top the movie. And they don't, they just look like shit. There's nothing that really gives them anything different. It reminds me of the piece of shit, movie. Let me think. Lost Boys, The Tribe. That's what the photos remind me of. It gives me the same bad taste in my mouth. So anyway, now we're to the part where
so bad you're crazy.
What am I? I'm Popeye, the sailor. And I am what I am, what I am, and I am what I am. And that's all that I am, cause I am what I am.
I am the law!
And I've got a lot of muscle, and I only got one eye. And I never hurt nobody's, and I'll never tell a lie. Top to me bottom, from the bottoms to me top. That's the way it is, till the days that I drop. What am I? I am what I am.
Q&A, and I'm going to answer your questions. First off is Matt, aka Ramble for Rap for Life, had some questions for the show. And he said, what are some of the worst films I've ever seen, and why are they the worst I've ever seen? Wow. I got to rack my brain here to remember some of the worst films I've ever seen, because if they're really bad, I just usually block them out of my mind. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to look up this, some bad movies somewhere. There's usually B-movie sites. Let's take a look, check at the IMDb bottom 150. Bottom 100. Probably bottom 100, I think. Bottom 100. Okay, their bottom 100 IMDb has. Fuck that, no. I'm just gonna go B-movies. B-movies.org. Let's just go horror flicks. I don't know, it's just. Oh, I think I want it. I absolutely thought Back in Business with Brian Bosworth sucked major ass. Most of the movie, what I remember, was Brian Bosworth's character talking about his issues to some psychiatrist, called himself Mr. Wrench, shitty action sequences, crappy acting, even for Brian Bosworth, and I did not like the black guy who was his partner. I thought he was absolutely lame. So that was a lame movie. Abraxas, Guardian of the Universe, which is one of the worst films I've ever seen. Shitty Terminator ripoff with Jesse the Body Ventura and Sven Olin Thorsen, I think. And it's just a piece of shit. Reason why it's bad. Horrible, horrible, horrible score. Do you think of jazz music when you think of an action movie? No. No. It has a jazz score. Completely out of place, shitty effects, and way too much product placement. And I have a big issue with movies like that. The Alien Dead, shitty movie that Fred Olen Ray basically stole money from local people to make it. Crappy acting, shitty effects, boring-ass movie, and it has a 25th anniversary DVD. That's why I'm pissed off, and that's why I think it's one of the worst films I've ever seen, because it has a 25th anniversary DVD with fucking special features, which is pathetic. Alien Prey. I'm just going to say this guy is an alien. He encounters two British lesbians, and this guy gets, when he gets it on and, you know, gets a Woody, he turns into some raving beast and likes to bite the heads off chickens and stuff. Fucking weird-ass, lame, boring movie. Even the tits can't save the movie, because most of the women, you just don't want to see them with their tops off in the first place. Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. I'm sorry, you know, everyone's cult classic. I think it just sucks. It's not funny. It's boring, and the jokes just don't work at all, in my opinion. So, if I didn't have the commentary script that my friend Damien Sage wrote for me, and I was doing the commentary in Killer Tomatoes, I don't think I'd be able to sit through it. It's not really funny. It's not clever. And if you like it, that's okay. But I just think it's pathetic and totally unfunny. And Killer Tomatoes are not scary. And I know they're not supposed to be. But the fact that that movie had a fucking, that series, that movie has a franchise is unacceptable. Give me a fucking break. That movie has a franchise. And those movies are on DVDs, the sequels, and not I Come in Peace. Seriously. Who the fuck wants to watch the Killer Tomatoes eat France or whatever? Stupid. Blades. I saw it with Matt, and I saw it before. Boring fucking movie about a killer lawnmower. It could be good, but there's no gore, and it's not funny. Attempts at jokes fall flat in the face. And too many Jaws references, more like it rips off Jaws, and it just is not at all really that watchable. It's a pathetic piece of crap. Get out of here, cat. And I don't want anything to do with it. Blade sucks. Plain and simple. Lame. Lame, 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 lame movie. Get out of here, fucking cat. Sorry, guys. It's just a fucking stupid cat bothering me. Anyway, Blades, just lame. Just, no. Blood Freak, shitty movie by a were-turkey. Yeah, it's a guy kills drug users with a turkey head. Then he turns into a turkey man, a man turkey. No. The Brain. I know a lot of people are like, well, it's a cult classic. I'm sorry. No. The Brain with David Gale, it's not scary. It's not really that original. And no matter what you say, the killer brains are laughable. They aren't scary at all. Fucking giant walking brains with eyes and teeth. Give me a fucking break, man. That's just pathetic. You know, really. Wow, no. Sorry. Carnosaur, because of that horrible, horrible, mean-spirited ending. And shitty. Cemetery Man. Yes, I'm mentioning Cemetery Man again, because I hate that fucking movie, because everyone gives it praise. And if you like it, that's fine. But I don't care for this movie at all. It's boring. It's a pathetic zombie film. There aren't that much gore effects. It makes no fucking sense, and the movie ends in a fucking snow globe, and I don't even want to talk about it anymore. I'll just start, my head will spin around. Let's see. Oh, The Cars That Ate Paris. Peter Weir's, one of his earliest movies. Stupid. That movie sucks. I'm sorry. If you're a fan of Cars Eat Paris, They Eat Paris, fine. Boring ass movie. It's not about killer cars that eat people. It's some fucking complicated drama infused plot. And there's one car with spikes on it. But it's fucking boring. I mean, it's a boring movie, and that's why it sucks. Da, 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 da. even though I grew up watching it, Double Dragon. Because it's a horrifying film. To the shitty acting by Scott Wolf, to the way that Alyssa Milano is dressed, it makes her, she doesn't even look hot at all. She's horrifyingly ugly. And Abobo. Abobo is a disgusting fucking fat fuck I did not need to see, and it's a pathetic movie. It's more enjoyable than Street Fighter the movie, because it's so bad it's good at times, but Street Fighter the movie sucks too, so that's on there too. Street Fighter the movie with Van Damme, and Street Fighter Legend of Kung Lee. And Elves, a movie I uploaded on my channel for some reason about killer Nazi elves. Yes, Nazi elves. Basically, really bad movies are all the ones I did for Trans Cinema. Those movies I never really want to see again, ever. I mean, Demon Warrior, fucking The Outing, The Last Slumber Party, Alien Warrior, No More! You know, and just sucky movies. Jacko, sucky piece of shit movies. Going to the H's here. Fuck. Heart Beeps. Not funny, boring, pathetic, weird ass movie. Stan Winston did the effects of robot Andy Kaufman and Bernadette Peters, and they go across this town, they cross the world to try to build a baby robot. Deserved to be a flop. Totally. Hard Rock Zombies. Give me a fucking break with that movie. Oh, the songs are okay. No, they're not. And the movie's fucking pathetic. It's not scary at all. It's got a midget Hitler in it. I'm not kidding. Midget fucking Hitler. Ugh. Even that doesn't save it. Midget Hitler doesn't save the movie. Cannibal Frogs. Now, a lot of people talk about that movie as if it's some classic. Like, it's better than Cannibal Holocaust. This isn't that. It doesn't have the production value as Cannibal Holocaust does. It doesn't have that great score Cannibal Holocaust does. I don't hate Cannibal Holocaust. Yes, it has a lot of horrible, bad, mean, dispirited, nasty things done on animals. But its premise is to piss you off, and it does it. Cannibal Frogs does it. It takes way too long to get to its gory moments, and they're effectively gruesome, but the movie's just dull. I mean, and the dubbing is horrendous. It's just not really that entertaining of a film. Neither is Cannibal Holocaust, but Cannibal Holocaust, to me, it's interesting because I'm like, you know, these guys are a bunch of a-holes, these documentary fucks, and they deserve what they get. Bad movies, all four of the Leprechaun films, or I guess there's six, but they all suck equally bad. I mean, just because the character is not scary, the effects suck, the deaths are laughable. Death by pogo stick! Stupid fucking movies. Why the fuck does that series have a fucking franchise? Fucking break with that. Fuck that. Ridiculous crap. Yes, I know people act like this is some trash classic. Microwave Massacre is boring as fuck. The effects suck. It's about some fat schlub of a man who goes around and kills women and microwaves them. It's not fun to watch. It's fucking laughable. It's not scary. It's a snooze fest. See it for curiosity's sake, and I'm going to watch it again for Trash Cinema eventually, because I haven't seen it in years. But I remember watching it, and I'm just like, this is fucking pathetic. That's what it is, pathetic. Night of the Lepus. All I gotta say is Bones McCoy, DeForest Kelly versus Giant Killer Rabbits. And that's all I really need to say. Giant Killer Rabbits. Giant Killer Rabbits. Whose great idea was that? Oh yeah, Tentacles. Tentacles is some 80s movie about like some killer octopus with a bunch of no name, you know, Shelley Winters, I think, is in it, some other stars. Pathetic movie, not scary, shitty effects. The octopus, a giant octopus gets killed by orcas, but you don't barely even see them. I've seen it once. Pigs. Pigs is a horrible fucking movie. There aren't that many, they call it Pigs, but really, there aren't that many pigs in the movie. It's a mean-spirited movie about human beings, movie about human flesh being fed to pigs, and it's boring, and it's so fucking dark, you can't see shit. So, fuck that. That movie sucks. Absolutely horrendous. I mean, wow. Blocked that one from my memory. Just looking through this bad movie, badmovies.org, I'm able to be like, oh wow, I remember that one. Fucking pigs. The remake of Rollerball. Why the remake of Rollerball sucks so much? It's directed by John McTiernan, who's done a lot better shit. And the acting sucks. There's no fucking suspense. The movie, it's just shitty. It's not even that original. It's like Future Sport with Dean Cain and guest starring Wesley Snipes, and I'd rather watch that. Rollerball just sucks. Superman 4, The Quest for Peace. Horrible film. Yes, I would rather watch Superman 4 than Superman Returns, but the movie still sucks. I mean, terrible effects. The Nuclear Man is laughable. He's not intimidating at all. With his, you know, you think if referee thinks the guy who roared like a T-Rex in Gangland is laughable, watch Superman 4 again and listen to Nuclear Man's shit that spews out of his mouth. You prick. And the fact that he's made out of gets his powers from the sun and he just scratches Superman in the neck with his Lee press on nails and now Superman's dying. Did any of these writers read a fucking comic book? I know the script was written by Christopher Reeve, so I'm like, Chris, what were you thinking, dude? I mean, may he rest in peace, but that was not a good decision. And for one, you put Superman, did you read any of the comics, dude? You don't get your power, you get your powers from the sun. You won't get weakened by the sun, that makes no sense. Pathetic. Come on, man. Seriously. Stars Crystal. You know, I don't really need to say anything else, except it's a shitty fucking movie. Fucking E.T. ripoff. All of a sudden, the alien wants to be a Jehovah's Witness at the end of the movie. And it's the only movie that I ever, as soon as I bought it, after I saw it once, I threw it away. So that is why that movie is one of the worst movies I've ever seen, because I threw it away. I still have Return of Captain Invincible. I still have Last Slumber Party. I still have movies like that. I didn't throw them away. They suck, but I'm like, okay, they're hard to find, so alright. But this fucking Star Crystal was bad enough for me to throw it away. You know it's fucking shitty when I do that. When I even keep movies, I even buy movies that are obviously pieces of shit, like I did 2 days ago in fucking this movie. Perils of Gwendolyn and the Land of the Yik Yak with Tawny Katane and some guy from Bachelor Party. And Tawny Katane was in Bachelor Party and the director of Just Jackin and some guy named Brent Huff. Yeah, I buy movies like this. And I threw Star Crystal away. So that's some serious shit there. The Spirit, that's another one. Frank Miller's The Spirit. Horrible fucking movie. Now his career is fucked. Rightfully so, if he's gonna release shit like that and call it a movie. I mean, some of the most ridiculous fucking dialogue I've ever heard in my life. Oh yeah, Strays. Timothy Busfield and Kathleen Quinlan and a bunch of killer cats. Give me a fucking break. Oh, there's three feral cats that are in the house. It's like, they're fucking cats! Seriously, give me a break with the killer cats shit. Silent Night, Deadly Night, Part 2, 3, and 3. Yes, I understand Matt doesn't mind Certified Fatal by Part 2. And despite, that's only the sequence that's good. The whole, you know, garbage day, everything else is boring. But half the movie's a fucking flashback. And I just don't care for that movie. And I don't care for the third one either. It's boring shit, piece of shit. Flame-ass movie. Sex Set. Yeah, let's watch Mae West, some 80-year-old fucking chick, you know, acting like, you know, being all sexy and wearing frilly, you know, it's horrifying. That's a horror movie. If you've ever sat through Sex Ed, that's a horror movie. Some 80-year-old octogenarian woman, you know, she's 80, over 80, and wearing revealing dresses with midriffs. It's horrifying. Stuff of nightmares. It's not sexy at all. Saturn 3. Yes, and I love the tagline. Someone left this on badmovies.org. Somebody saved me from old naked Kirk Douglas in space. Yep, that's right. Totally nailed it right there. Wow. Another bad one is Chatterbox. And unless you don't know what Chatterbox is about, Chatterbox is about some chick who talks with her vagina and sings. Her vagina sings. Fucking movie. Fucking lame movie. You can see it for curiosity's sake, but my god. Shitty. Oh yeah, Baby Geniuses. Rugrats live action movie. What the fuck was Kathleen Turner and Christopher Lloyd thinking being in that movie? Not funny. Not even enjoyable. I would watch Baby's Day Out again rather than that. Time Runner. Yes, somebody travel back in time and warn Mark Hamill about this movie. Seriously. Sheesh. Even with the Mystery Science Theater 3000 commentary, that movie was still boring as fuck. Well, oh yeah, your Hunter for the Future, of course. All I could think about is a bunch of dicks. And Zardoz. All I have to say is, the penis is evil! So, that's only the tip of the iceberg, but I think I answered Matt's question as long as fucking bull. Next he asked me, what films disappointed me the most? And then I thought I would be good or great, instead of severely disappointing. Well, recent ones, Explorers, childhood film of mine, very disappointing with a very horrible ending. Extremities, draws me in, shitty ending. Brain Scan a little bit. I mean, you know, it's kind of, I kind of usually try to block those movies from my memory, the ones that are disappointing and aren't as good as I thought they would be. In a way, I can say Cemetery Man was like that, because I hear all these people gushing about it. I watch it, and I'm like, that was horrible. So, they were disappointing most of the time, because my expectations were either really high, you know, or I bought into the hype. So, that can be that way. Iron Man 2 is another one that was disappointing to me. Too long, and just too much plot involving the Avengers and stuff like that, but... Yeah, and mostly almost all the films that came out last year were disappointing to me, except Expendables and Red and a few others, so. Matt, Ramble Rat for Life, then asked me, will there be any future video game videos like what I did for the Predator NES game? Hopefully there will be another, some more episodes of the Shitty Games series. I just need to download another Super Nintendo software so I can record the footage. I did a cliffhanger one, but it didn't record the video, so I didn't edit it or anything because it didn't record any video. So I'm thinking about doing either a cliffhanger, this is a Super Nintendo game, or really what I'm planning on doing is, for the next episode of the show, I want to do one about, you know, action heroes from the 80s. And I think I'll throw in some, you know, just action heroes, really, just about the action heroes, like Stallone, Schwarzenegger, Van Damme, Seagal, you know, all those guys, even underrated ones like Jeff Speakman. I'm just going to talk about them for the entire show, and I'll take questions from you guys about it. But I'm going to play some on the show. I'm going to put the footage, you know, edited in there, and I'm going to play some crappy games starring action heroes. Lethal Weapon on the SNES, and, you know, Cliffhanger, Demolition Man, True Lies on the SNES, stuff like that. So, yeah. To answer your question, Matt, yes, I will be doing more of those. Then another good friend of mine, Effrey, he sent me some questions. Like, he said, who's my favorite horror icon? I gotta be honest, it's Freddy. I mean, I didn't want to get introduced to the Friday 13th films really that much in any time in my life. I watched Nightmare on Elm Street films more. I was more in tune with those. Freddy's my favorite horror icon because I like his pop culture, you know, when he did his pop culture stick, I liked it. I thought it was funny. He was effectively scary. The films were inventive, and that's why I love the Nightmare on Elm Street films. Some of the deaths in those movies are some of the most inventive kills in entire history of horror cinema. So, that's my favorite horror icon, is Freddy Krueger. He said, what's my favorite video of Effrey's, of his, when he used to be on here? That's going way back. I'd be honest, I liked his Rant on the Crow remake. That was a lot of fun to watch. And there were some other ones, but I can't really rack my brain around some of these things right now. His recent rant video he did was really good, so you should check that out. He does a little, you know, Tom Roslin sniffing some coke, so that's pretty funny. And he asked me, could I talk a little bit about Frank Zito, Joe Spinell? Oh, you mean that pit-faced schlub of a man, you know, that there's no way in hell he should be getting a hot chick like Carol Monroe with his pit face and zits everywhere and, oh my God, and his mother complex? Yeah, seriously, Joe Spinell is not a looker. And if you see the last horror film, AK Fanatic, you get to see him in lingerie, and that's equally horrifying, so, yeah. Pit face, love of a man, and panties and a bra. Not good. It said, what is my favorite actress? I don't really know if I have one. I mean, I like certain actresses. I'm not like, there aren't movies where I see an actress and I'm like, oh my God, I need to watch it. I like Sigourney Weaver. I enjoy Kathleen Turner's work. I like, from what I've seen so far, of Heather Thomas, I like her a lot in Cyclone. You know, Barbara Cramp, didn't like her in her movies. Cynthia Rothrock is fun to watch. I mean, I'm not like, oh god, I have to watch her, the movie that she's in. I like Jamie Lee Curtis, Rebecca De Mornay, Kim Cattrall, early Kim Cattrall, not newer one. And I don't know, it's Kathleen Kinmont sometimes, and Gina Davis, The Longest Goodnight. So, that's really, and I like her in Cuthbert Island, so, there aren't any actresses that I'm like, oh god, I need to see the movie that she's in, you know, but yeah, I guess those are basically, you know, the type of chicks, you know, actresses that I like in my movies. Here's another question. The guy FYTJ said, what's my most embarrassing moment? Well, it's an embarrassing moment. Oh, wow. I really don't know. Embarrassing moment. Only one that I can really remember right now is, well, I went to Paramount's Great America, a theme park. Went on the Top Gun ride. I didn't get anything to keep my glasses secure. So we're going on a 60-mile-an-hour barrel roll. My glasses fly off, and I'm holding my glasses while going in the 360-spin barrel roll, and I can't see shit. So I'm, like, going on the fucking Top Gun ride, and it was embarrassing because, well, I mean, fuck, I almost lost my glasses. And what made it even more embarrassing was that when I went on another ride where I stand up, my mom took her shoelaces off and tied them in the back of my glasses, and I looked really dorky. So I guess that's really as close to about as embarrassing moments I can get that I can think of right now. That was pretty embarrassing, looking like a dork with shoelaces tied around my neck. So, some more questions here. We have questions from Kentucky Cunkator. He said, what are my thoughts about the quality of horror films today? I really think they suck. I know a lot of people have been talking praise about Insidious. It's a PG-13 horror film. I don't know how much they can get away with the PG-13 horror film. I'm looking at it as going to be another one of those films that are trying to be shocking and chilling by putting a lot of weird, freaky shit in the corners of your eye, or a person can't see it, but you can. And, you know, from what I've seen, it just doesn't seem that scary or that inventive. I saw the trailer. I was not impressed by Insidious. Maybe we need to check it out. I mean, Aaron Rice 007, he liked it. But I'm just not impressed with horror films today. They're either a remake or a sequel. Some remakes are good, most of them suck. But most of the time, they just don't have the originality they used to have. They don't have the casting they used to have. They don't have the casts that are funny and, you know, the stories suck. The character development is next to nil most of the time in these horror films nowadays. You don't really care for most of the people at all. I think it's also the decade we're in. It just sucks for popular culture. So the films just don't work. Too much of those, you know, found footage genres, and that's actually one of the questions asking me. Too much of the, you know, they did the whole Japanese remake craze, and that was shitty. And horror films nowadays just try too hard to shock you. They try too hard to give you the jump scare. You know, they don't really care that much about character development. They care more about the jump scare. And they don't really want to be fun anymore. And that's a big problem I have. Horror movies aren't fun to watch anymore in the theaters unless I talk about, like, Piranha 3D. Most of the time, they just aren't fun. You know, they're just there to just make people scared and throw their popcorn in the air and have your girlfriend cower at your shoulder or something. But not that it's a bad thing, you know, hot chick, you know, that's good. But I don't think they're that original. I don't think they're that inventive. And I don't think they're that scary. And I just don't. No. So I think horror films today in this decade suck ass. I would rather watch the cheesiest, crappiest B-movie horror film from the 80s than watch crap in the theater that comes out now. Because at least they have an excuse. They know they're crap because either Troma's producing it or so they're working with a low budget. Films nowadays, like The Roommate and The Stepfather, get released in theaters and it's bullshit because they're pathetic, insipid movies. I mean, they are just... PG-13 horror films suck. I hate them. I can't even think of one PG-13 horror film that I was like, that was awesome. I can't think of it. So Insidious, maybe it's good, but it's still PG-13. They can't get away with that much. So unless they're going to do a lot of jump scares and some kids freaking out and going, you know, all over the place, or sending some chickens flow levitating shit, whatever. But it's PG-13. So horror films, Ducky can cater, I think the horror films today suck. That's my opinion. Am I a fan of the found footage genre? Like I said, that's a part of the reason why horror films suck nowadays. No, I'm not. I like Cloverfield, okay. I don't like Quarantine as a shitty ending. And I hate the Paranormal Activity films. They're hailed as original, inventive, and scary, and whatever this. I've seen the first one. I haven't seen the second one. I don't want to. The first one, I'm like, this is pathetic. I mean, it's boring. There's no fucking character development. You don't give a shit about these characters. You don't care if they get killed by some ghost. You don't give a shit. It's not like Poltergeist where you're like, I actually care about this family. I don't want anything to happen to them because they're almost like my family. They don't give a shit. It's just about the jump scares in Paranormal Activity. And I don't like it. I'm sorry. It's disorientating for all the, you know, and who wants to be disorientated? I mean, no one really wants to be disorientated. I don't want to be like, wow, my head hurts. My head's spinning around. That's great. That's a great experience. I hate those movies. And the ending, every ending that movie came up with was lame. The ending they used in the theater was lame and totally predictable. So screw, I don't like the found footage genre because it's part of the reason why horror films suck now. Because they do too much of the found footage films. And Paranormal Activity is going to have a shit ton of movies now. Because it's been popular. So, look forward to see Paranormal Activity 3 this year. I just, fuck that. I don't like found footage genres. I don't really care for them. I didn't even like Blair Witch Project. So, he said, were the 1980s the best era for cinema? Detective Kunter, you nailed it on the head. I really think it was the best era for me, anyway. I think it's the best era for cinema and music. The 70s started it. The 70s started the, you know, the revolutionary, let's do more with films. But I think the 80s took it and ran with it. The 80s are the best decade for movies, in my opinion, because they know what they're most of them were original, they were inventive, and they were a lot of fun to watch. They were entertaining. The 80s made movies to entertain movie audiences. They didn't make them to make them think. They didn't make them to make them be all like, oh, wow, what convoluted plot are we going to throw in here? You know, the 80s were the best decade for movies, in my opinion, because that's what they did. They were there to entertain you. They weren't there to bore you to tears like Inception. That's why I think Dreamscape is a movie that's miles better than Inception, in my opinion, because Dreamscape is entertaining. The effects aren't that great, so what? Inception is overblown, overrated, and I don't care for it. And the music is just too much. So, but anyway, 80s are best decade for cinema, I agree. I mean, for horror films, definitely. The early 80s, for the slasher film genre, some of the best horror films out there. Best decade for remakes. I mean, The Thing, The Fly, The Blob, those remakes are just as good, if not better, than the originals. You know, great horror film franchises. Nightmare on Elm Street, the first Child's Play came out in the 80s. Hellraiser. The 80s are the best decade for movies, period. Ghostbusters, Ghostbusters 2, Indiana Jones, all these movies come from the 80s. The Goonies, The Monster Squad, almost all my favorite movies come from the 80s. Just every single one. So, that's a testament to that decade, and it was great. And I wish I was there right now, really, honestly, because that sounds like fun. But anyway, yeah, I totally agree. It's the best decade for movies. Then he asked me, Kentucky Connecticut asked me, who are some of the most overrated directors working today? Christopher Nolan. I'm sorry. I think he's overrated. That's my opinion. If your movies don't make that much sense and they're boring me to tears, I think you're overrated. So I get a lot of people giving me shit, but fuck you, I don't care. That's my opinion, I'm sticking with it. I do not like Christopher Nolan, I think his movies are just fucking boring. That's it, I think they're boring. I don't think they're inventive and original, I just think they're there to make me fall asleep. If I want to fall asleep right now, and instead of taking a sleeping pill, I'll go watch Inception. So, that's an overrated director. Sam Raimi is another one. His early work is great. Spider-Man films, no, okay? And his recent track record sucks. John Carpenter used to be great, not good now. Wes fucking Craven is one of the most overrated directors ever, in my opinion. Here's why. Nightmare on Elm Street, still his best film, okay? He made some good films. Surfing the Rainbow, Shocker, he made some good movies. Recently? No. He's just making Scream 4. He did fucking Cursed. He's just sucking it up right now. He did My Soul to Take. Wes Craven is overrated because he only has a handful of films that are any good that he's directed. And he's considered some classic director. And the same thing for Tobe Hooper. Tobe Hooper's way more than overrated. He's not that great. I mean, he's done Texas Chainsaw Massacre, great movie. What else? Poltergeist, okay? And Life Force, and I enjoyed that okay. But everything else sucks. Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2, okay. But everything else he's done is lame. Night Terrors, Eaten Alive, Spontaneous Combustion, it's totally overrated. Justin Lin, don't like him. I hate his camera work with his fucking shitty Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift movies. So, you got that. I like Zack Snyder, but I kind of side with people. He's sort of overrated because he just focuses on visuals. He doesn't work on his stories. He focuses on the visuals. He doesn't have a good story to work with, like 300 and Watchmen. Those are already good, great graphic novels. Sucker Punch is his first foray into original idea, and it sounds really stupid to me, and the fact that it's all in their head, and Baby Doll is, they're all perfectly made up, and there's no suspense to any of these sequences, because you automatically know they're fake, and it's going on in their head. So, yeah, I don't like that either. So, I guess that's all overrated directors I can think of. Well, I mean, I've been rambling on, but I think I'll give you guys one special treat. I actually went to some bookstores a couple days ago, and I got some stuff. Just thought I'd show it to you guys, because books don't really work in just updates, in my opinion. But this is what I'm doing, and afterwards we'll get to the last part of the show, which is, I show you three random movie trailers. I'm not telling you what they are. And you tell me what movie I should pick to review on the show. I mean, I was going to review a movie on the show, you know, today. I just don't know. I'm not feeling it. You know, just don't really know what to review right now. I haven't watched that much recently, so really a bit not really going to work. But, you know, I'll set it up so you can choose what you want me to review in the next show. next month. But anyway, got some magazines. This is one called Film Threat Magazine. And Film Threat Magazine is some independent magazine. And I got this one. This is issue 19. It's got an interview with Clive Barker. It's got an interview with the actor from Street Trash, Bill Chappell. It talks about Return of the Swamp Thing. It talks about Nick Cage. And it has an interview with Brian James. You know, and it talks about the horror show. So that's pretty cool. So I got that. Then I also, that was $3. Got this for $1. This is kind of like Starlog type preview magazine. It's a British magazine. And it talks about Indiana Jones, Temple of Doom. It talks about Gremlins. It also talks about Streets of Fire, which is cool. It talks about Streets of Fire. Some nice photos in there about Streets of Fire. It talks about actress Laureen Landon and her movie Hundra. It talks about Ghostbusters. Favorite movies. It talks about Indiana Jones, Temple of Doom. Used to be my favorite indie movie as a kid. Talks about Dune. Special effects. Talks about Greystoke, Lord of the Apes, Christopher Lambert and Christopher Lambert's first films. Quest for Fire. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And I got these. These are pretty cool. These are the Dark Side. It's like Fangoria, but it's like the British version of Fangoria. It's got cool 3D Freddy Vision cheesy thing in the back here. So that's kind of cool. And this one talks about all different kinds of stuff. Night of the Living Dead remake. Talks about the makeup of the Kurgan. Talks about how they did the makeup for the Kurgan, Clancy Brown and Highlander. It talks about horror video games, early ones from the early 90s. It does a review, some video reviews of Shockma, Bikini Island, Strays, Extra 2, Freddy's Dead, Freddy the Dark, Psychic. It talks about the makeup effect. Talks about this movie called Deadbeat by Dawn, which by looking at the effects work, I really want to see it. This is some of the effects work in Deadbeat by Dawn. And it's a guy who created this thing called Charlie's Family. I like this look right here. Something like dirt base or something like that. So that's Deadbeat by Dawn. Sounds like some really good effects work and zombie work in there. Then it talks about Michelle Bauer, the actress. Michelle Bauer. It's a nice little photo color thing of a bunch of hot chicks. See it very well, but yep, there you go. It's got Michelle Bauer, Kelly Maroney, Brink Stevens, Mona Gabriel, and Roxanne Kernahan. I think in the middle, that's Kelly Maroney, I think. I think that's in the middle. Kelly Maroney's in the middle. I think. Yeah, I think the blonde's Kelly Maroney. Talks about Ian McCulloch, Italian actor, who was in Zombie Flesh Eaters, Alien Contamination. He was in The Beyond, that's what they called Beyond back there. And it was Zombie Flesh Eaters, or City of the Dead, I think. So talks about horror novels and stuff. And then, yeah. So that's The Dark Side, the first. This is issue October 1992. This isn't issue one, of course. This is the other magazine I got. This is April 1992. This is The Dark Side again. And this is the Trauma Special, and it basically talks about trauma films. It goes A to Z of all the trauma movies. which is, you know, I don't care for the trauma films that much. Some of them are fun to watch. So it's kind of cool that it goes A to Z for the trauma films. Calls it traumatized, like traumatized. It's pretty cool, I have to admit. So it talks about the guy who played George Eastman, who was in Anthropophagus, you know, the Beast, and they call Beast Man. They talk about his roles in Absurd and other movies he's done. It talks about some more video reviews of, like, Popcorn, Dead Space, Stepfather 3, Neon City, The Rocketeer. It talks about, Naked Lunch. A little bit of Naked Lunch. And talks about some more horror books, fantasy novels. Talks about Evil Dead 3, Army of Darkness. So, Evil Tunes ad in the back there. And then, those are the mags. I got this book at Goodwill for $4. This is called Tricks of the Trade. It says special effects, stunts, and makeup. How it's done. And some really cool photos, makeup effects photos, like Ghost Story. Stick Smith's work in Ghost Story. Alice Krieg. Right there. Alice Krieg. Scary. That's American Werewolf London on the other side. Nice American Werewolf London photos. You know, cool stuff. Fluffy from Creep Show, Dawn of the Dead, Exorcist. It's really cool. Talk about sometimes they come back again. Cat People, the remake. Nastasha Kinski right here. Making her up here on that right there on that side, making up Natasha Kinski on that over there. Then we have Company of the Wolves, talking about the effects in that. The Cyclops. They talk about a. You know, the guy from the Fury effects, talks about stuntmen, all types of stuntmen. It talks about, it shows, this is really cool, from Company of the Wolves, the puppet that is a mechanical flesh puppet. Pretty cool stuff. And then it also talks about all kinds of stuff, puppetry, firework, Christine, the car from Christine, their Dragon Slayer. This book was released in 1986, so it's not entirely up to date like some of my other makeup effects books. But it's, you know, special effects books, but that's pretty cool too. That's the spider from Crawl. And, but it's pretty cool. I mean, for $4, that was definitely worth it. And also talk about Superman. They made a flub in early in this book. They said that this photo right here, they said it's from Halloween 2. And I'm like, wrong, that's Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. Which is an underrated film in my opinion. And then go to trying to find the one photo that scares the shit out of me to this day. Yep, this photo always fucks me up every time I see it. The childhood memories. So, let's see. What we got? this right here. This fucking fucks me up. Scares the shit out of me. And you can't tell me that's not fucking you up too and making you feel fucking like you want to lose your lunch or run away. That is fucking horrifying. That just looking at that again, I'm like, ugh! You know, look at it, and I'm like, ugh! This is what I do every time I look at that, and I'm like, ugh! That gives me the creeps. So, that was a good find. Then here are some books I wanted to get. This one I've been wanting to get for a while. And I picked it up. I always like Fab Press. They do a great job of books. They did the Friday the 13th Camp Blood one. They did a shock horror. And this is by a really good author. This is the same guy, Jamie Presley. Jamie Presley, it's called Book of the Dead. And Book of the Dead, there's another zombie book out there, but this is Book of the Dead. And it talks about all different types of zombie movies. It's got really nice full color photos of like Dead Alive and shit. I mean, gory, bloody, fucking awesomeness. So, and I got this for like $16 or something like that. And only just a copy I saw. I mean, I probably could have gotten it somewhere, but the only copy that I saw of it was Ghost Town a little bit. And talks about every kind of fucking zombie movie. 70s zombies, well, you know, new zombies. There's a lot of good essays and stuff about zombies. So, everything you think about zombies, it talks about. It's like the ultimate zombie book. I mean, there's some other zombie books out there. The other zombie encyclopedia is pretty good, too. Eventually get that, too, but this is really cool. And basically, got a lot of color photographs and black and white stuff, and it talks about all different types of zombies. It even talks about voodoo and early zombie movies from, like, you know, the 30s, and so it's cool stuff. So, yeah, it's, like, over 300 pages of awesomeness. So, I got this one, The Book of the Dead, and I also wanted to get, you know, I saw Powell's, I don't have all the money in the world, but I was over at Powell's, and I saw Crystal Lake Memories, you know, the Camp Blood, you know, Crystal Lake Memories, you know, the big Jason, you know, Friday the 13th making of franchise book with all different interviews from guys and full color photos. $35. I'm like, if I had it, I would. Now, but there's this one book I really want. It's called Nightmare USA. And it's about the history of the exploitation horror filmmakers. And they only had the display copy up there. I was like, well, where's the actual copy? And they just had the display copy. They didn't have the actual book. So I'm like, that's just bullshit. But anyway, I want to get a copy of that. But I'll wait till later. Till I got more money on hand, and then I'll get a copy of Return of the Living Dead book. The making of the Return of the Living Dead franchise is awesome. And Amber USA, maybe Camp Blood. So, you get those off Amazon sometime. Here's another thing I got. It's called the Official Splatter Movie Guide. It's not that big. John Russo. John McCarthy did it. He did some other good books that I might want to check out. He did a Volume 2 that I want to pick up. I always wanted to get this. It's from 1989. It's not that in-depth. It's got some good photographs in here, though. Some rare photos. It's got some nice photos. You know, aliens. Stuff like that. Good photos in here. Talks about just all different types of horror movies, really. That's all it really does. Photos from Blood Diner, and Hellraiser, and Fly, Beast Within, Rawhead Rex, on this page right here. Beast Within, Rawhead Rex, Carrie, Conan the Barbarian, which seems way out of place. But, yeah, it's got some nice VHS cover art here, too. Like, there's New Blood, Friday the 13th, and New Blood right there. And then there's some more cover art here. That's kind of a badass cover for The Hidden. Badass VHS art for The Hidden. pretty cool. Better than what they have. Class of Nukem High poster. Film I did later part 2. Japanese poster for some Spookies and Zombie Nightmare. Spookies, the second artwork, was the first artwork is pretty cool too. Spookies, it looks like it has great. They had a bunch of great artwork for those. But yeah, this is Splatter Movie Guide. It talks about other stuff too, not just Splatter movies. Death Wish and the Annihilators and Action Movie and stuff, so it's pretty cool. $7.50 for that one. And then these are the last two books that I picked up. Darkness Falls, the novel. Darkness Falls, the novelization. And Colors by Joel Morris. He also wrote the novel for Lethal Weapon. So, those are the books that I picked up. So, that's really about it, folks. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed the show. It's a long, long show. But I hope you join me next time for the next episode of the show next month, where I'm going to talk about action movies. Action movies heroes. You know. Action heroes, you know. Stallone, Schwarzenegger, all those guys. So that'll be fun. And yeah, and just, I'm going to tell you real quick about one thing I'm going to plan on doing. I want to write a book. I don't know if it'll be published because a lot of copyright crap I got to deal with, but I want to write a book about horror films, the ultimate guide to horror films of the 70s, 80s, and early 90s. It's basically a trivia book about all different types of horror films. Talking about if I can find some behind the scenes stuff on the makeup effects, I will. I mean, I will do that. So I'll be talking about films from the 70s, 80s, horror films, 70s and 80s. 70s, 80s, and early 90s, and I want to call it Gory Days. Gory Days, as if it's the glory days of horror. You know, so that's what I'm going to talk about. Gory Days, the ultimate guide to horror films of the 70s, 80s, and early 90s. So I'm going to start on that. I might actually, if I ever do finish it, send out copies of it to my friends. So, and you know who you are. But anyway, thanks for watching the show. I hope you enjoyed as much as I did doing it. I mean, I'm getting kind of a little bit long in the tooth, getting kind of tired. But I hope you enjoyed it. And once again, the show ends with 3 special movie trailers. I haven't seen any of these movies either. So, 3 movie trailers of movies I have not seen. That you watch the trailers. You leave a comment below here. Leaving a vote of which one you want me to review on the show. Doesn't matter. Yes, the next one's going to be about action heroes. Still going to throw in a review. If the movie's about a horror film or action movie or comedy, it doesn't matter. I'm going to review one of those in the next episode of the show. So, thanks for watching the show, and I'll check you later. All right. Bye.
A new age of combat.
Human beings, genetically engineered to be the best fighters in history.
2 champions.
It isn't over until someone wins.
At war with each other.
Killer, I have already killed you.
2 invincible men.
Let's finish it, Alexander, here now.
The ultimate killing machines.
I'm gonna get in this thing! And I'm gonna kick your...
The battle's over!
Not for me.
our galaxy is split into two warring factions, our own and the one ruled by the evil Count Zartan from the League of the Dark Worlds.
The Count has created a weapon. A weapon so vast, so huge, that it would take a whole planet to conceal it.
You must sail to the haunted stars. Find the Count's secret planet and destroy it.
Greatest mistake. What unknown terror was born that night? What is the terrifying mutant that strikes from behind the shroud of night? That night of the Lepus. A night of total terror, more shattering than your strangest nightmare. What caused the unnatural death, destruction, and panic? That night of the Lepus. Janet Lee. Stuart Whitman, Rory Calhoun, and Paul Fix. Night of the Lepus. Kill one, and thousands take their place. What devil creatures growing weight and size every day are hidden behind the eyes of horror? What can stop them? Night of the Lepus. From MGM.